Hey everybody, welcome to Glenette's Cow Emporium. It's Nette, Whiskey Mama in the kitchen. Today, I'm doing something that I haven't done before. I think Glenn has, for sure. But you know, working at home now and kind of feeling a little bit back to the basics. So join me today while I make my own Wild Thing sourdough starter. So I sterilize my jar. We are on the farm, and I did have some distilled water, but it was kind of old, so I thought, well, let's try this. So I just boiled some tap water for a minute, and I let it cool down, okay? And there's a ton of videos out there where some really smart people are making sourdough, or their families have had it for a long time, and right now, I can tell you, I am not that person. But just for fun, I'm going to do this. Don't mind the dog in the background, he's just freaking out a little because he's missed chores again. Actually, Glenn went to the bar. So what am I going to do? I'm going to put 3 tablespoons of flour into my jar. 1, 2, 3. Now there's some really people who have really fancy measurements. That's not this one. If you have been watching this channel for any length of time at all, you know that I'm not really a fancy kind of person. So, alright, so my boiled water, okay, 2 tablespoons of that into the jar. Okay. Now we got like this going on. So I just have a fork. You could do the whisk, you could use a spoon, I don't care what you use. You're just going to stir that so that all the flour gets wet. You want to use unbleached flour for this. I'm just using white flour. A lot of people like to use rye flour to kind of start their starter with, and I'm not really fancy that way. So already I'm breaking the rules. So my stuff's a little dry, so I'm gonna just add a tiny bit more water in. I'm gonna know if I've wrecked this or I've done something wrong is if in 5 to 7 days I don't see some action out of this sucker. Okay? So today's day 1. We get all the flour in the jar mixing up with a little bit of water that was in there. And it says not to cover it completely because this thing does this cool thing where it creates this this gas inside of there, and it will basically cause a small bomb in your jar. So yeah, we're not going to do that today. I really don't have time for bombs in my life. So anyway, there you go, D1 done. I'm going to put a loose fitting lid on this, and I'm going to just leave it on the counter where it's going to be nice and warm, and we'll see what's up tomorrow. Welcome back. It's day 2 for the Wild Thing sourdough starter. It looks pretty firm in there. It smells okay. I was encouraged to see a little bit of bubbling, some holes forming at the bottom of my jar this morning when I looked at it. I sterilized some water. I'm just waiting for it to cool off. Okay. So I'm going to feed this sourdough starter with exactly the same measurements that I put in there yesterday, first day. So I'm going to do 3 of tablespoons of flour. And I rewatched the video that I learned this from, and it's by weight. That's why there's 3 tablespoons approximately of flour and 2 of water. So by weight, they would be. Now I'm not going to add any more of that quite yet. I'm going to give this a stir in. I see some people's sourdough starters are actually like decently wet. So mine's pretty happy to have the addition of that new stuff by the looks of it. Again though, I'm going to add a little bit more water. And it's possible that it's because I don't know where we are in the world. We're in southern Alberta, Canada, and so that's this. I'm a lot happier with this. Like, I think that it's not gonna grow if it doesn't have like a little bit of moisture happening in there, right? So anyway, there we go. Okay, all right. Back it is tomorrow. Hey everybody, today is going to be my last day with this sourdough starter. As you can see, I got a little excited and then remembered that I was filming this. So see inside of here? See all the bubbles? I am so excited. I would say that this is a complete success. So I split it, okay? Because you can get too much flour stuff going on in there and it's just a big glob of flour. So I'm gonna feed each of these the way that I fed the other ones, to use it to make some bread in a couple of days when I have time. Because I'm gonna tell you, the starter stuff is easy to do. The bread stuff, so much time to make that bread. But I see that you can use the sourdough starter in more things than this bread, so I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna look into like pancakes and bunch of other stuff. So anyway, thanks for joining me for this sourdough starter. If I can do this, you can do this. Have fun!